Elevation 44. It's your girl B, and if you're new here, welcome, and if you're returning, welcome back, family. Today we're diving right into another moon energy video, and we're talking all about the Pisces full moon. Now, outside of the Scorpio full moon, this is my favorite full moon of the entire year. It's my favorite over Scorpio, but it is the most magical outside of the Scorpio full moon. I mean, this energy lends itself to mysticism, dreams, and deep emotions, okay? And it's just really a magical energy because it's dealing all with the spiritual realm. This is taking us beneath the surface and going down into the depths to really tap into the deepest parts of ourselves. So I really, really love this energy. It's special to me because I had so many revelations around a Pisces full moon and started so many new things in my own spiritual journey around a Pisces full moon. So it'll always hold a special spot in my heart, okay? So the Pisces full moon is actually happening on, let me look on my notes, Wednesday morning. So Wednesday, September 2nd at 1:21 a.m. So this is the night of Tuesday going into Wednesday morning. So I would say the peak times to work with this energy again are 2 days before and 2 days after the full moon. So we're talking about up to Sunday night. So starting early is Sunday night, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and I would say Thursday should be the last bit of that, like the strongest energy around working with this full moon. So if you want to plan out your activities between Sunday and Thursday, that would be the peak time, and the night of the full moon, that Tuesday night going into Wednesday morning, or even that Wednesday night will probably be the strongest energy out of all of those days. So just giving you that information if you want to, you know, plan your activities around that, okay? So when the Pisces full, when the moon teams up with this Piscean energy, what we're talking about is being highly receptive and highly intuitive. Two things that are so important for us right now, especially with the state of how things are around us. It's like, you know, we're moving blindly, so we have to be able to see with the eye that counts, right? So being receptive and being highly intuitive at this time is what is going to really help us get through these times. So this energy is actually coming right on time. The overall theme of this full moon is really going into the hidden depths and being led by our intuition and tapping into our deepest emotions, right? We are also being led to identify what are our spiritual values and how does that match up with how we move in the material world. So that is pretty much the overarching theme that I'm pulling out of this particular full moon, and I'm not gonna waste too much time. I'm gonna get right into it so that we can get to the meat of the video, okay? So some of the facts of Pisces are, it's element is water, so this lends itself to emotion, imagination, sensitivity, and spirituality, okay? The quality is mutable, so that means this energy is very adaptable or flexible. The house that Pisces rules is the 12th house, which is the house of spirituality and the unconscious mind. The planet that rules Pisces is Neptune, and Neptune is all about illusions. It's all about mystery. It's about glamour, and it's also the planet that brings a lot of disease in, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, okay? The polarity, which is the energy that is that is opposite to Pisces energy, or that sits exactly across on the astrology or zodiac wheel, is a Virgo, okay? So if Pisces energy is very dreamy, is very about spirituality, about the unseen, and, you know, imagination, Virgo is the opposite of that. Virgo is grounded, Virgo is practical, and Virgo moves and is focused particularly on the material realm. So you have those two contrasting opposites, but the energies are actually great to have, you know, a balance of both, okay? Because we do need the spiritual aspects and the unseen aspects, that dreamy energy that Pisces brings in, but we also need that grounding, and we need that the material focus that Virgo brings in. It's all about having the right balance. So that's why I want to mention the polarity so that you guys get familiar with the energies and how you need to have a balance of both, okay? Now, the gifts of Pisces are mysticism, empathy, psychic enhancement, clairvoyance, idealism, creativity, imagination, receptivity, compassion, and intuition. On the flip side, some of the challenges that the Pisces energy can bring in is being overly emotional, overly sensitive, indecisive, anxious or nervous, having tactics of escapism, especially in terms of drugs and alcohol, feeling disoriented or confused, like your head's in the clouds constantly, insecurity, deception, and being secretive, okay? So that those are the, you know, the two contrasting different types of, you know, challenges and gifts that can come in with this Pisces energy, okay? Now, the focus for this energy, which I kind of touched on when I introed the video, is really allowing ourselves to be spiritually led, okay? Because right now, we are in just a time where things are just up in the air, right? It's just big question mark, right? I mean, life is really a big question mark if you really think about it, but it feels a little bit more ungrounding than usual, right? We feel a little bit more just kind of like, you know, ripe for the picking, so to speak. A lot of people really just have no basis or no firm hold. So this is giving us a chance to be spiritually led. So this is tapping into our intuition, our dreams, and paying attention to the signs and symbols around us, because a lot of the times we can feel and sense things before they actually happen, right? We're looking outside of ourselves for answers that we already have within. And this is a massive problem, especially as people are living religion and moving over to spirituality, right? It's like they're leaving religion, but their mindset hasn't changed much. So they're looking to everyone outside of themselves for answers that are within, like I said. So looking to spiritual teachers or gurus or leaders in the community for answers, constantly looking for tarot readings or tarot cards, or like literally living life looking for answers from others on how to make the next move, what's going on. It's like we know these things. We can feel it. We can sense it. We have intuition. We have our higher selves for a reason guiding us, and we need to learn to tap more into that. So using this energy and this full moon to get more connected with that part of you so that you can trust yourself and you can be led in the direction by your higher self. It's time to, again, allow our higher selves to leave. We're tapping in to that very spiritual part of ourselves, and to that that part of ourselves that society has taught us to ignore, to tell us to just focus on the material. The spirituality stuff is not real, and don't believe in things that you cannot see. But it's actually the opposite, right? Everything is flipped, really, and it's like believing in the things that you cannot see, because those are the things that actually come into existence in reality when you believe them. So, I mean, everything that you've been taught is like a complete upside down or a complete flip. It's just, you have to retrain your mind, and you have to retrain your mind in a lot of ways to trust yourself and to be individually led and stop looking for something outside of yourself, someone outside of yourself to give you answers, to tell you where to go next, what to do next, how to move next. This is your life, this is your journey, this is your path, and you know what is exactly best for you. And if you have not been living in that, this is the time to tap into living in that way. So use this energy to your advantage to get more aligned, okay? Now, this is also a good time, like I mentioned before, to address any of your conflicting desires between your spiritual path and your material and the material world, and how you're living in the material world. So, you know, you may have aspirations to spiritually be at peace, to, you know, whatever the case may be for your particular case, but then in the material world, it doesn't reflect that. You're engaging in things that are the opposite of whatever your spiritual desires are, right? So it's a good time to kind of dive into that and see, does that line up? Does my spiritual desires actually line up with what I'm doing or what I'm going after or how I'm spending my time in the material world and trying to get those two things to align a little bit closer together so that there is a harmonious aspect of exchange working between the spiritual world and the material world to your benefit, okay? So let's talk about some of the transits that are happening at the time of the full moon. I'm only gonna talk about the aspects that the moon is making to some of the other planets, because if I talked about all of the aspects that are happening, we'll be here forever. I also put out a weekly video that talks about the energies for the week, so I will talk about those transits of the other planets in that video. So if you're interested in seeing more of that type of content, the overarching energies for everything, then I would definitely go check that video out when it comes out on Monday, okay? So, I just want to go into the moon transits. Now, the first thing that's gonna be happening is that the moon, okay, which will be in Pisces, is going to also be hanging out with Neptune in Pisces. So that means it's getting some influence from Neptune in Pisces. And what we have here is everything that I mentioned before, all of the gifts on steroids, okay? So we're talking about heightened consciousness, emotions, heightened sensitivity, heightened intuition, heightened creativity, and vivid dreams and clear downloads. So this is a really good time to, like I said, tap into those things, tap into your intuition, start getting aligned with your higher self, because those downloads, those things that we know that we can sense, we can feel it before we know it to actually be true, are gonna be coming in sharp, clear, and fast with this energy, okay? So this is putting all of that energy on steroids. On the flip side, it is also putting those challenges on steroids as well. So it's heightening everything like deception and delusion, self-destructive behaviors, anxiety and confusion, okay? So just like we're getting the gifts heightened and boosted up, we're also having the challenges boosted up. So you're gonna have to be very aware of, you know, both sides of the coin, using those gifts to your advantage and then making sure that you don't fall in the traps of the others, and just being very, very aware, self-aware. This is also Neptune, like I mentioned before, is the planet of disease. So this is also a time of heightened infections and diseases, okay? So this is a time where your immune system can feel suppressed and low, and you can be more susceptible to picking up something. And with everything that is already going on, I wouldn't be surprised to see a new wave of things kicking up, or just, you know, there's a whole lot of crazy going on right now. And like I said, this energy is just literally going to boost that, okay? So just be particularly vigilant with how you're taking care of yourself, making sure that you're protecting your energy first and foremost, because when your energy is down, that's when the body goes down, okay? So your spiritual energy, your chi, that life force, you need to keep that, you know, keep it moving, keep it high, staying away from the drugs and alcohol during this time, anything that is going to, and the negativity and anything that is going to suppress that chi, suppress your immune system and make you more susceptible to getting sick is, you know, something that you need to watch for. So I just want to make sure that I put that out there so that you know. The other thing that is going to be happening with the moon is the moon is going to be sextiling Uranus in Taurus, and this is a harmonious aspect. So what Taurus usually focuses on, if Pisces is focused on the spiritual world and the spiritual aspect of things, Taurus is really focused on the material world, okay? So that's another earth energy, just like Virgo. It's very grounded. It's very plugged into the material possessions and collections and money and that type of thing. So with this exchange of energy happening between the two, we also have a heightened or stronger intuition, okay? And our instincts will just be on point, on point, on point, on point. Again, trusting yourself and what you're hearing from your inner voice and knowing that to be truth and going with that instead of looking outside of yourself, okay? I'm gonna keep repeating that because I know somebody needs to hear it more than one time, okay? You're also more likely to be able be in the spirit of embracing change right now, okay? Coming up with new concepts or original way of doing things. And again, this is very much tied to connecting, like what I said, our spiritual values to our material world or our material values and making those line up, okay? So this is a time where we're gonna have a new and original ways of thinking about how to make our material world more closely align with our spiritual values and everything like that, okay? So this is a great time to embrace new things and break old habits. The only thing that I wanna say to watch for with this aspect happening with the moon and Uranus is that Uranus brings unpredictability and change and quick changes. So with that combined with the moon, which is our emotions, we're talking about changeable moods and emotions. So things that your moods can be up and down, you know, can we're already going to be in a really, really sensitive spot. We're already going to be, you know, in the deepest depths of our emotions. So, you know, with that, those quick changes, you might be on a little bit of an emotional roller coaster. So just don't be surprised if you have strong emotions or waves and things coming in and out that that take you into different places, okay? So, you know, just, you know, try to remain as balanced as possible and try to ride the wave pretty easily, okay? Let's talk about some of the herbs that you can work with during this time. Elderberry, lavender, witch hazel, yarrow, sage, milky oat, nettles, linden flower. This is because Pisces is all about the water and that water element. You can also work with sea plants like, you know, sea moss or Irish moss, it's the same thing. Kelp, bladderwrack, so anything that is a sea plant. So those are also good herbs or plants to incorporate into your rituals or, you know, to use during this time, okay? So let me get some of the crystals that I have. All right, and I have three to talk to you about, but I only have two with me because the other one, I thought I brought it with me and it's not here. You know how I do, guys. You know how I do. And before I get into the crystals, I will mention that I also have the Pisces moon tea that is available on the website. I'll put the link in the description below, and it tackles a lot of the things that we talk about: intuition, astral travel, clairvoyance, psychic dreams, and spirit communication. So everything that Pisces full moon is bringing in, this tea is gonna help boost that. It has all the herbs and everything in it to boost you and take you to the next level, okay? Because it's all about, you know, us accomplishing, empowering ourselves and accomplishing our goals. So I make these products to help you with that. So that is also gonna be available on the website. I just wanted to mention that really quickly. And so the crystals that we're gonna talk about, the first one is amethyst. And amethyst is a great crystal, especially as you're working with the spiritual world. It's everything connected to the upper chakras. So it's great for your third eye chakra. It's great for your crown chakra, both to see that intuition, that seeing past the surface and the, you know, just kind of like the material and what's in front of you, seeing, and then also being able to get those downloads and to make sense and get that wisdom, which is the crown. So the amethyst crystal actually has other amazing properties or qualities to it, but this is what I'm going to talk about in relation to this Pisces full moon and how to use it with this Pisces full moon. So amethyst is great, and it's also a great protection crystal. The next one I don't have with me, but it is my favorite crystal of all time, and I say it like in every video, and I show it in every video. So if you have been watching my videos for a while now, you already know I'm talking about labradorite. It's called the stone of magic. It really is. And like I said, this is like one of the Pisces full moon outside of the Scorpio full moon is one of the most magical full moons ever, okay? So it is really great to use labradorite with this full moon because not only does it have amazing protective qualities, especially when it comes to psychic protection, because if you're going to be working with magic and working in the spiritual world and everything like that, you're going to need to be protected in that way. So using these protection stones in your work is of the utmost importance. I'm telling you, please make sure that you continue to protect yourself as you do your work, okay? Especially if you're doing spirit communication and all kinds of other things like that, or traveling, astral. We'll get into that in a second, but it is great, okay? It's great for that. And also, the last one I'm gonna show you is It's a tiny, tiny piece. If I can get to focus. Yes, this is aquamarine. And this was actually gifted to me by a Native American medicine man. He gave me this to put into my medicine bag. So I actually feel like a special connection to this crystal. Although I love all my crystals, like I really love this one. But anyway, the aquamarine is really great because it's great for occult powers. It gives you serenity of the mind because again, with this Pisces energy, we can be head in the clouds. We can get, you know, we can be very prone to confusion and delusions and all kinds of stuff. So this can give us some serenity to make our mind a little bit more at peace. Okay, and this is also great for occult powers, and it's good for, I think I mentioned that already. I don't know if I mentioned that. I'll mention it again. And this is also great protection stone, okay? So this is aquamarine. So those are the three crystals that I would recommend you working with at this time. Now let's get into some of the rituals that you can do with this energy. And like I said, because it is the most magical full moon of the year in conjunction with the Scorpio full moon, this is great energy for all forms of magic, sex magic, candle magic, spell work, whatever you want to do, the magic that you want to do, this is a great energy to practice all forms of magic, okay? Just make sure you're protecting yourself. Make sure that you're protected in your work. But I would say the focus of rituals that I think that would be most beneficial to use with this energy are spirit communication, okay? So talking to the other side, talking to the spiritual world, divination. Another thing, and so divination is anything with, you know, using your tarot cards, or you can be, you know, you're looking into a crystal ball. You can practice divination in many different forms. So divination is also a very strong one, because and that's also going to strengthen you to help you with your third eye, to help you with receiving downloads and all kinds of things in the spiritual world, okay? Another ritual that you can do is astral travel or lucid dreaming, and I think of them as one and the same. So astral traveling to me is when you're doing it, when you're like intentionally awake, and to me lucid dreaming is just like the version of astral traveling while you actually go to sleep, right? So basically the astral travel is literally allowing your astral body, your spirit body, to leave your body while you're consciously awake and travel to different places. That could be different places on this earth, that could be different places in this universe, or somewhere else completely, you know, out of this universe and out of this dimension. So there are different places that you can travel with your spiritual body, and you can also do the same type of traveling while you're sleeping, and this is called lucid dreaming, where you go to sleep but you're actively, you're consciously aware of traveling while you're sleeping, okay? And you can navigate different things, different dreams, and go into different records. You can go into the Akashic records, you can travel to different places, you can go to alternate timelines. There's so much that you can do with lucid dreaming. I'm not gonna get into it too much. I have an entire video, actually I have two videos where I talk about lucid dreaming, so I'm going to link one of them up here somewhere or down in the description box so you have a little bit more guidance if you are interested in lucid dreaming, okay? So another ritual that you can do with this energy is past life regression. And I recently had a past life regression session. I actually did it myself. There are actually guided videos here, right here on YouTube, where you can, you know, basically listen to a guided meditation that takes you through your past life regression. Now, the benefits of past life regression are basically you get to go back and start to piece together lessons that you may have missed in your previous lifetimes that are relevant to the lifetime that you're currently living in, and that, you know, so that you can learn, so you can tie in like where did you miss learning certain things, why are you the way you are in this lifetime, certain things that you can see that directly correlate, certain lessons, and you can also see The people who are in your life now and see how they have been with you, those spirits have come with you, your soul tribe, over lifetimes trying to master yourself, right? So they may show up, you know, in different forms in your other lives. So, you know, who may be your husband in this lifetime might have been your sister in a previous lifetime, or your mother, or, you know, it's like you start to find that resonance of energy, even though the outer costume or avatar looks different. So it's really cool to kind of just piece together a lot of those lessons that we may have missed in the previous lifetimes and why we're still experiencing certain things and what we have left to master while we're here. So I really, really, really recommend past life regression for anybody who is interested in just kind of really diving deeper into why things are the way they are for them now in this lifetime and how to kind of move beyond certain things, okay? Certain lessons and stuff like that. Another ritual that you can do, because Pisces is all about that water energy and there's a cleansing element that can come in here, you can do a spiritual bath, okay? So just water cleansing. And I have products on my website for spiritual baths, but one of them that I'm going to mention is the Lucid Dreams bath soak. And this bath soak is amazing for a spiritual bath, and it's also great to help you. It's like double, because you're getting a spiritual bath, there's a cleansing element to this, but there is also the element of helping you with your lucid dreaming. So if you're interested in doing that, I have this, and then I also have the Lucid Dreams tea that is back in stock, because that I cannot keep in stock. People love the Lucid Dreams tea because not only does it help you lucid dream, it also helps you sleep peacefully, and a lot of people are having a hard time sleeping with this energy. So those two products are available for that, but I also have two other bath soaks that you can use for other things like shadow work and self-love and stuff like that. So taking a spiritual bath and cleansing yourself, cleansing those energies that build up those, you know, on you as you move about throughout the world, or just, you know, releasing certain things is very helpful to do, and it's something that you actually should be doing routinely, okay? So a spiritual bath is something that I would definitely recommend. It also will strengthen or give you a clearer channel of communication with the spiritual world, so that you are getting those downloads, that you're being able to communicate with your spirits, with your ancestors, your spirit tribe. It's just going to open up that line of communication and make it a lot clearer for you to hear and digest and receive certain things. So that's why spiritual baths are so vital as well, okay? The last thing I would do with this energy, if you can't think of anything else or none of these other things have appealed to you, you can always express or show gratitude. Being grateful and having an energy of gratitude is always going to attract more abundance into your life in all types of forms, spiritually, emotionally, physically, mentally, you know, in so many ways. So if I always tell people, like, if you don't want to do a specific ritual, if you're unsure of something that you want to bring in, or you can't think of anything, or you're just content, just show gratitude and be thankful and just ask for wisdom and guidance and just, you know, and show love and just, you know, love on yourself and thank your spirit tribe and, you know, everyone that is working together with you on this journey, because you're not alone. You know, that is the misconception, that we're doing this alone. We're not doing this alone. We have a lot of assistance, unseen assistance, and we have spirits here that come down with us and take on the forms of our husbands, our children, our mothers, our you know what I mean, our best friends, that are actually helping us through this journey, because we're all ascending and growing and learning together in pods. So I would, you know, just go ahead and express gratitude for that. The people that are in your life, the people that you don't know, the people that are helping up there, you know, the spirits that are helping up there, and just being grateful. And I feel like I'm rambling, so I'm gonna go ahead and close out this video. I don't have any more information for you, but please let me know in the comments below what you are looking forward to with this full moon. How do you plan on using this energy? And if you found this video helpful, I want you to please give it a thumbs up and share it with somebody who might find this information helpful. I really just aim to put these videos out to provide guidance and to help you navigate this energy, because there is just a lot going on, but there's also a lot that we can do, and we actually have a lot more control of things than we actually are led to believe. So when we take back our power, we see the things around us change, okay? For the better. So that's the purpose of these videos. So thumbs up if you like it, or share, subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you all in the next video. And if you're Pisces, if you're Pisces gang, Pisces moon, Pisces sun, Pisces rising, go ahead, drop your sign below. Love to see when you guys shout yourselves out. I don't have a lot of Pisces friends. I don't know a lot of Pisces. I know a couple. So I want to see who's a Pisces. Drop your signs below, okay? I will see you all in the next video. Bye.